Okay, so I want you to take a second to really look at this check, and it's already filled out. And all these questions below, we are going to go one at a time, and we're going to fill out the answers to them. So whoever wants to volunteer to tell me the answers can raise their hand. Not yet, but they can, or you can just put your answer in the chat, okay? Whichever one you feel most comfortable with. So let me get my tool ready to write on this. So please don't annotate it. Let me do the annotating. All right. Who can tell me whose name is on this checking account? Orion, I saw your hand up first.
Curly Smith.
Boom, you got it. Yep. And the way that you can find that is you simply look at the check, the top of the check, and you look at the name, right? Because this should be the person whose checking account it is. So someone tell me number two, who wrote and signed this check? Kenna, can you tell me who wrote and signed this check?
Carly Smith.
Yeah, kind of a little trick question. It was the same person. Nice. All right. From what bank was the check written? This one's actually, I don't know if I told you guys this one. Let's try Leilani. I don't think I've called on you today. You want to guess what bank?
J.A. Biztown Bank.
Yeah, amazing job. So usually your guys' bank name will be written somewhere on your check, right? So that the cashier or whoever you're writing this check to can verify what bank it's coming from. Oh, you guys are eager to answer. Whom was the check written? To whom was the check written? So who was this check written to? Kaden. You there, Kaden? You want to answer?
Oh, sorry. I thought you said someone else.
Who is this check written to?
Birthday card.
Oh, try again. One more try. Who was it to? Who are they paying for the birthday card?
Oh, fantastic cards.
Yeah, you got it. And I see a lot of you guys got it in the chat. Amazing job. So remember, the company or the person, the business, whoever you're paying goes on the pay to the order line. I know it gets a little confusing sometimes. Who can tell me what is the check amount? Let's try Eric, if you're there, Eric. How much is this check for?
$3.25.
25 cents, nice. Cool, great job. All right, what's the account number, Zoe?
It's 083.
Yes, and I see all your guys' chats, correct? Now let me tell you something. I know this is the same number that Lisa's check was under. It was the same number that all of yours was. Let's be clear, you will not have the same checking account number as anybody else. No two people will have that same account number. So this is kind of just an example, but this will never happen, okay? Now, why was the check written? Where can you find that information? Let's go Dylan. Dylan, why was this check written?
For the birthday.
Yep, because it looks like Carly was purchasing a birthday card. Yep, and you can find that on the memo line, okay? That's where you find a little note to themselves or the person that they're purchasing from, what the check is for. And then what is the check number, you guys? Where can you find the check number? Do not confuse it with the account number. Haley? Wait, I actually can't see it because of the little bar at the top. Hang on. Yes, it is 1563. Oh, you guys got it in the chat. You're so quick. Okay. I know this should be fairly easy for you guys because we just did all this, right? You're pros at it. Okay, that was really it. I was going to have you guys fill out a check register, but we didn't practice doing that in depth. And I do want to go over the last thing that I want to show you guys, but great job. You guys did that with ease. And I appreciate all of you who rose your hand. That was awesome. Nice. Let me clear my drawings. And let me show you the very last thing that we are going to do. We're just going to sum up today's learning. Okay. So I want you guys to show me with your thumb. I want everybody to lower their hand. First of all, I see a lot of hands up still. Just go ahead and lower your hand. I want you guys to show me either with a thumbs up or thumbs down if you guys agree or disagree with the following points on here. So we're going to go through them one at a time. You guys are going to show me your thumbs according to what you believe. So do you guys believe that writing a check is one way that people withdraw money from their checking account? Think about withdrawal. Think about what that means. Do you believe that is true or false? I see a lot of you with your thumbs up. So withdrawing means taking money out. And when you write a check, you are purchasing something most of the time. You are taking money out. So that is indeed correct. Nice, you guys. Okay, what about the deposit tickets? We talked about deposit tickets. Think about the deposit ticket that I told you that sits on the stand in the bank when you go to deposit a check. Did you guys see a signature on that when I showed you it? Try to remember. Do you agree that you must always sign that deposit ticket? Yay or nay? I know I showed it kind of quick, but what do you guys think? Okay, I'm seeing some mixed answers. So I know we didn't go over it a ton, but actually you do have to sign a deposit ticket. Don't worry if you said no, because again, we didn't go over it a ton, but you pretty much have to sign anything that has to do with checks. You got to sign the front of it. You got to sign the back of it. You got to sign the deposit ticket. So when in doubt, sign. Oops, I went backwards. Okay, tell me, you guys, if you think if there is not enough money in the account, a personal check will be returned to the account holder, the person who wrote it, and they must pay the amount of the bad check and usually a high fee. Remember this silly little word? If you can remember, so if you agree with this, thumbs up. If you don't agree, thumbs down. And then in the chat, type in the word for this. When this happens, the check blanks. It does something. Nice. Aubrey, you got it. Oh, everybody got it. Yep, that check is going to bounce. So that is correct. Okay. You will owe the bad check and it will bounce if you don't have enough money to cover that check. Okay, number four, all transactions should be recorded in the check register. Do you guys agree with that? Think about what the check register was in your checkbook. Is that where you record transactions? And what I mean by transactions is that where you record when you write a check, when you receive one? Yeah, you guys got it. Yep. Mm-hmm. You should definitely do that. Okay, you don't want to go in the negative. You don't want to go in the red. So you got to always keep track of your balance. We've all been thumbs up so far. Last one. A paycheck and a personal check are the same thing. Do you guys agree with that or disagree? Are they the same thing? We talked about them separately. Think about it. All right, you guys are pretty quick with this one. They are not. This was our first thumbs down. Yep. You guys got it. All right. That was it for today. We learned all about checks, all about what's in your checkbook. Hope you guys had fun. I hope you guys feel confident about writing checks. So thanks, guys.